And we are back with U.S. Open qualifying coverage on CBS Sports Network, presented by Heineken. A beautiful day in Flushing Meadows, Queens. Adam Zucker, Jimmy Arias with you from the shadows of Arthur Ashe Stadium. And we are not even halfway through our first eight-hour run here at Qualies. Day one, lasting all through the week. And, hey, Arena Falcone in no rush either, but she is advancing 7-6, 7-6. She played every day growing up in Inwood, the Inwood section of Manhattan, and now she's on to the second day of Qualies.
It's fantastic when you're a local. You got the crowd behind you, obviously, and she does have a great chance, I think, to go on and qualify here. She has done well in the main draw in the past. She plays well in her hometown.
We will see her against Lucic Baroni. Now, the real treat for all the fans here, it's not only free tennis to come watch as long as you want, and the weather is cooperating, the food's great. You get to watch the biggest names in tennis as well. And, of course, they're all trying to get through Labor Day weekend when our coverage will continue here on the CBS Sports family of networks. Third round coverage, round of 16 coverage beginning at 11 a.m. And at 10 a.m. each day, things begin with today at the U.S. Open on CBS Sports Network. But the fans here, they get to see the big names rolling into town now and loosening up and getting warmed up. And Andy Murray, among them, a major attraction here, going through some service practice earlier.
Well, he does need a little service practice. That's a part of his game. His second serve has been a little suspect this year. But, boy, did he have a nice run here in 2012. His first Grand Slam title, he was a guy who had been in four finals in the past, couldn't get past that final round match, and then against Novak Djokovic, an incredible five-set win for Andy Murray, avenging a loss in the finals of Wimbledon to Federer, and he finally got a Grand Slam title.
Yeah, he got it going. It took 4 hours and 16 minutes, and he started what seemed like it was going to be a good, long-lasting run, and you referred to how things have tailed off a little bit. As you look at the last five champs, of course, Rafael Nadal will not be here because of the wrist injury. Del Potro won't be here either, and Roger Federer. It was Roger Federer's face on all of the previous five before that list.
Look, we showed you Andy Murray. I was a little worried coming into this year for Andy Murray because he won Wimbledon. And that was a dream, I'm sure, as a kid. No Brit since Fred Perry in the 1940s had won Wimbledon. He finally accomplished that feat. And then he had back surgery at the end of last year. And you weren't sure if he'd ever work that hard again to get to that level. And you know what? So far this year, he hasn't. He's been a quarterfinal loser at all the bigger events. I think he's starting to play better this summer. He had a great match in the quarterfinals at Toronto against Tsonga, the only guy to get a set against him. Lost to Federer in the quarterfinals in Cincinnati. Federer won the tournament. So he lost to the two guys that won the tournament. I think he's starting to play better. He's here early, getting used to the courts, getting used to the conditions, practicing. Maybe this is his chance with Nadal not around.
There you go. And so the big names are rolling in. The lesser-known guys, they're competing for a spot tomorrow. Three wins it takes this week to get into the main draw. More live tennis coming up here on CBS Sports Network as we continue on day one of U.S. Open qualifying. Alexander Zverev and Yusutaka Ochiyama when we continue from Flushing Meadows.
Mic check, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, Warren, here we go, bye-bye.
Here I am.
Come on.
I'm on.
Let's go. Welcome back, everyone. Court 11. Men's qualifying singles first round for the U.S. Open. Yasutaka Uchiyama against Alexander Zverev. We are in the first set. We are on serve. Zverev from Germany, born in Russia, now in Hamburg, Germany, his hometown. Serves near court. 30-11 in this game. Power player, 6'6". Against the Davis Cupper from Japan, Uchiyama. Welcome back to Court 11, Dave Ryan, Channel Rubin, seven-time WTA titleist, former Grand Slam doubles champ. Conversation from Zverev here with the chair umpire, Kelly Thompson of Great Britain.
Well, that forehand from Zverev was awfully close, and he thought it caught the line, but of course no challenges out here during qualifying.
Big serve, 40-15 for Zverev, ranked number 157 in the world, only 17 years old. Against the 22-year-old Uchiyama, ranked number 242. A little emotion here from the German.
Well, that's 2-1 game that he was just sure Zverev were in.
I can see them all.
That doesn't help.
He's taking a long look at this one, isn't he? Kelly Thompson clearly saw, look wide there. No video challenges anyway, so you got to move on.
That's part of it, is managing your emotions and managing when you feel like there's a bad call against you, staying positive and moving on.
That court had a good break. We are about 2 miles from the field here at Flushing, Queens. LGA LaGuardia Airport is right next door, so you hear a lot of planes coming and going throughout our coverage. When the main draw starts, the inbound-outbound routes change a bit, not to go right over the tennis center. Not during qualies.
Games start.
Holds, keeps us on serve here. In our first set, best out of three, 3-all. As we said, Jenna, just a youngster, born in Russia, moved to Germany as a five-year-old.
And he was the number one junior in the world, Zverev, last year, and has started making some waves on the ATP Tour already, but this is his first experience at a Grand Slam event. So a lot at stake for him, but certainly a great moment for Zverev as well.
And watching this match, you and I, before we picked up coverage after the women's match on court 17, see how deep Zverev returns serve. Facing Yasutaka Uchiyama of Japan, as we mentioned, 22 years old, born in Sapporo, Japan. 135 career singles wins and his first U.S. Open appearance. Got to be exciting for these young players.
Well, unlike Zverev, Uchiyama played in the qualifying at Wimbledon and the Australian Open this year, so he's had a little bit of experience and maybe a slight advantage in terms of that, but Zverev hits the ball big. He has a big serve and a lot of upside.
Holds.
Backhand winner down the line for Zverev. That was a heater for three break points, looking for the first break of the match and a 4-3 first set lead.
Well, this is great balance from Zverev, and he knows exactly where he wants to go, doesn't hesitate. That's a confidently hit shot.
Boy, is he deep. First break attempt for either player. 6-6, those long strides. He steps up, gets the ball to rise a bit, but second serve, return spot, a lot closer to the baseline. Beautifully done. Backhand winner on the serve return. Break and serve, our first of the match. Underway, court 11, men's qualifying on CBS Sports Network. We're underway, our first day of coverage. Don't forget, ESPN's coverage begins Monday at 1 Eastern here from the 2014 U.S. Open. Four-three. Zverev breaks Uchiyama in the far court. 6'6" German serves, looking for a 5-3 first set lead.
15. That's been the difference for Zverev is the serve. He's won a high percentage of points off of first serves. And Zverev has been able to have easier service games, so he's been able to devote a little more attention to breaking and was rewarded in that last game. Capitalizing on that breakpoint opportunity.
14.
He's won 12 of 13 after that ace. First serve points. Now has four aces in this first set. 5 and holds at love for a 5-3 first set lead.
And this is only going to get better for Zverev, but so far it looks great. That serve, he has a very fluid motion, smooth, relaxed. There's not a lot that can go wrong with that serve. Five aces thus far. Now Uchiyama, a little bit of pressure on him, serving to stay in this first set.
15.
Uchiyama has 5 ITF level singles titles, 8 doubles titles, sort of the minor leagues of the ATP Tour. Doubles title at the Pro Circuit Challenger in Maui this year. Double fall for 15 all. Mentions his first time ever at the U.S. Open qualies. Did play at Wimbledon and the Aussie Open, as Chana talked about this year. Best ranking as a junior was number 12 worldwide in the ITF junior rankings back in 2010.
13-15.
Well, he's had Uchiyama some players to look up to. More players from Japan now on the men's side working their way up in the ranks. Nishikori is the biggest one that comes to mind. Goseda, who's also is also playing here. Oh. And as a young player, that helps 14, to see 15. Other players from your country, you know, making it through, maybe helping you along, giving you that little bit of extra motivation. Of course, for Davis Cup, being able to interact with those players. He played doubles, Uchiyama, with Nishikori. All of that helps in your development.
Second ace, Uchiyama holds, but is down 4-5 in the first set. Zverev of Germany serves for set number one, best out of three, when we return to the U.S. Open. Video on USOpen.org is your premier source for match highlights, analysis, press conferences, and behind-the-scenes coverage. Visit USOpen.org. Hey, Brian Channel, Ruben with you. Court 11, Zverev, Uchiyama, men's qualifying first round. And this is our 47th year of coverage on CBS, CBS Sports Network, of the U.S. Open.
Where for Zverev, where you gain the experience closing out sets when you have an opportunity to serve for a set on the pro tour. A little bit different than playing in juniors. As you climb up the ranks playing on the ATP Tour, WTA Tour, you don't get as many opportunities. And you have to capitalize and take advantage of them, especially when you're serving. That's a weapon that helps in these moments. Keeps the pressure on Uchiyama. And that's well done from Uchiyama to get that return back to get it deep, neutralize that first serve from Zverev, and then follow it in and be aggressive.
Not a lot of net play so far in this match. Big serve again, the service winner.
14-13.
And a set point here for Zverev. Going to go up one set to none in the best of three. And she will do. 6 ace first set and a 6-4 first set victory for Alexander Zverev of Germany. Second set coming, best of three from Flushing. Up the middle, the heater.
featured an epic match between 17-year-old Monica Seles and 15-year-old Jennifer Capriati. The match went to a third set tie break, where Seles came through. Seles would go on to defeat Martina Navratilova in
second set underway from court 11. Zverev from Germany able to break and then consolidate for a 6-4 first set win. Uchiyama from Japan serves far court.
Well, Uchiyama coming up with a couple of big serves of his own to start the second set. Important for a Japanese player to hold right out of the gate, reestablish himself to start this second set. Particularly after losing the first set.
Big forehand winner.
15.
Uchiyama competed in the U.S. Open Juniors in 2009 and 2010. Third round of the singles in 2010 was his best result.
When it was tough off that return, once Uchiyama popped that ball up, Zverev, he just did not hesitate. That Zverev has, and it's why he has such potential, such upside. At 17 years of age, 6'6", he has the weapon on the serve. He has the big forehand. He's not afraid to attack and move into the court. And those instincts of attacking tennis will only get better as he plays at this level. And he's a little feisty out there.
We've seen Zverev at least three instances.
Well, remember, Zverev, he got to the semifinals of his first event, ATP 500 level event, a big event. 17 years of age, was the youngest player to do so at that level. You have to be feisty. Break point opportunity here.
Can't convert this time. He was one for one break opportunities.
Jeez.
Helped him win that first set 6-4. And that ATP event in Hamburg, his hometown in Germany. So imagine the emotion and energy
that was difficult
going into that run all the way to the semifinals. That was history making. Only 17 years and 4 months old.
Well, that's well done from Uchiyama, holding his ground here. Playing well behind the serve. He's taking care to get those first serves in and do some damage with it.
So at 17 years old, 4 months youngest to get to an ATP semi since 2006. Marin Cilic did it. The hometown fans rooting him on. Drop shot.
Another game.
Uchiyama. That's a smart play from Uchiyama. Zverev, he goes so far back behind the baseline during some of those points that the drop shot is the perfect play. How far back Zverev is in the court. There's no way for him to track that drop shot down. A way to start the second set. Uchiyama dropped serve at the end of the first set, so still have some positive energy, positive momentum, played well. throughout most of this match thus far.
Sharapova was telling Zverev to hang on for a second. I don't think he heard at all. Just kept on going, but wins the point. Okay.
It's a little bit on edge at times, Zverev. Perhaps a couple of those calls have.
Drop shot of his own.
A little bit lucky on that reflex volley from Zverev. Completely mishit it, but to the aggressor goes the spoils. Important to move in and close and not hesitate going forward. Even though it wasn't a great drop shot, can improve on that.
He acknowledges he got a little lucky.
Faulty.
Started with the first serve, well placed out wide.
Game serve.
Easy put away, easy game.
One game.
Zverev evens the second set at one all after winning the first 6-4. Only one break so far in the match. Alexander got that to help him win that opening set.
We mentioned he was the number one junior in the world last year. He won this year's Australian Open Junior Championship. That really gave him a lot of confidence. He's gotten to the semifinals of the U.S. Open Juniors and also the finals of the French Open Juniors. So very proficient at the highest levels of junior tennis.
The American Stefan Kozlov in that final. A big junior title. That's what the call is all about, right? Michael Russell, we just saw on court 11 at 36 years old. He's keeping his career alive. Still going, grinding through the qualies. But a player like Zverev, only 17, future superstar, wants to make a name for himself, make that main draw.
The opposite end of the spectrum.
Exactly. Interesting storylines here.
And Zverev, he's got the confidence you have as a top junior player. You're used to winning. You're used to being in the later rounds of events. Sometimes it can be difficult to make that transition into pro tennis where you're not always in the later stages of events, and you have to learn to deal with that. For a player like Zverev, who has the confidence from being one of the best juniors, just have to use that confidence, but continue to build, continue to grow, use opportunities like this to get better. And certainly he's done that as the match has gone on, has three breakpoint opportunities here, Zverev.
Looking for a second break of the match. Not quite yet. Third ace for Uchiyama.
And for Uchiyama, you know you're playing against an up-and-comer. You've been hearing talk about this young 17-year-old, and you just have to stay focused on your game, your side of the court.
Mitch Long questioning the call a bit. Looked long to us live on that second break attempt. He'll have one more.
Well, it's been interesting to see what Zverev has been seeing on some of these balls. They looked out like that one did. A well-hit forehand, but clearly long.
As was that. And for the second time in the match, Alexander Zverev of Germany has broken Uchiyama for a 2-1 second set lead. We'll try to consolidate when we return to Court 11. Alexander Zverev, heavy serve, to say the least. 6 foot six and six aces in the match so far.
Well, the serve from Zverev is so smooth, so rhythmic. He produces with very little extra motion, and he's able to hit the different areas of the court with the same toss, the same look. So it's very difficult to read that serve. Zverev now serving up a break here in this second set. Already six aces in the match.
Fluent in German, English, and Russian. Youngster was born in Russia and moved as a young boy to Hamburg, Germany. Trains there and in Saddlebrook, Florida. And some of the English you heard from him speaking with Kelly Thompson, the chair umpire. Sounds like an American teenager to me. It's impressive.
Well, this is the time in a match where you're up a set and a break for Zverev, where everything can start flowing even more. You can relax even more on that serve, and the big forehands really let the game come to you. Beautifully hit that backhand. He got a little bit of spin on it, got his body under that ball. Not easy for somebody 6'6 to get down that low.
Done, blasted backhand return, Uchiyama. Zverev's brother Misha is also a pro. He's ranked in the top 500, injured at the moment.
That second serve a little bit short in the court. Uchiyama hasn't had many opportunities to get on top of the return. Has another second serve here.
Holds for 3-1 second set. He's looking very good right now for the German Alexander Zverev. His father Alexander, a former pro, now his coach. Great tennis family.
He's very athletic, Zverev, around the court. Even at such a tall height, gets down, he gets behind his shots, he's comfortable off the ground. Kind of like a Todd Martin was. Hit the ball beautifully from the ground.
You're right, very graceful for such a tall player. Tremendous reach, good footwork.
Doesn't quite return as well as Todd Martin did, but can grow in that area. And that might be a good play for Uchiyama to do a little bit more of. Bring Zverev in on his terms. Really try to control the play a little bit more from the ground. Well, that ball just long, but a beautiful roll on that backhand from Zverev. Dresses the ball nicely on that side. 30 love here for Uchiyama. Vitally important for the Japanese player to hold serve.
Forced error numbers to date. You're right, can't possibly afford another break. Oh, Steve, right through.
Blame it on the wind.
City Field, home of the Mets, is
was it
hop,
me?
Skipping a jump away. Whoa.
He just took his eye off of that ball, Zverev. And blame the court a little bit, I guess.
Change up. Uchiyama holds. Down 2-3, though, in the second set. Qualifying is underway. Everyone wants to make the main draw next week. Because you had to be a big shot. Had to open up your mouth. You had to be a big shot. We mentioned Zverev at 17 years old, 4 months. For 17-year-old since 06, Cilic to make an ATP 500 semifinal. Also the youngest ever, turns out. Swinging volley, easy winner there, not bad. Rafa Nadal was 18 when he won the 05 Barcelona title. Second youngest, officially. That's pretty impressive.
Very impressive. Well, he was the youngest to get to the semis of a 500
right.
ATP level event. But obviously, Cilic got to the semis of an ATP Tour regular event.
The big tour.
Exactly. But so impressive from Zverev. This young of an age, the poise that he has. You can see that here today. It doesn't help, doesn't hurt, I should say, to have a big weapon that can get you out of trouble, that can get you those easy points. The serve from Zverev allows him to take a few more risks in the other areas of the court, and especially off the return.
To 15, still a couple points for 4-2. Dave Ryan, Chad Rubin with you from Court 11. Rest over Taylor Dent handling Court 17. And some of the great tennis we've seen there today.
Game.
Blasted cross court forehand winner. For 4-2, second set, a 1-set-to-none love. Katrina Stewart. Katarina Stewart, excuse me, from the United States has a lead. Daigle Zimer. 3-2 first set, best out of three. Quali's underway.
First round of the qualifying, not the quarterfinals, but still like a quarterfinal for many of these players. They have to win 3 rounds to get into the main draw. get on the big stage.
So Uchiyama in big trouble here, down 2-4. If you're his team, what are you thinking about for a comeback? How do you engineer one?
Difficult with the way Zverev has been serving. That's been the big problem for Uchiyama. He can't afford to have a letdown on his service games, which he has had a couple of times, and Zverev has stepped up.
Three balls in play.
That's where the pressure comes. If you're a server like Uchiyama and you have somebody who's hitting the cover off the ball, plus you don't get many opportunities on his service games, there isn't a lot of margin, and that for him is beautifully hit.
Point, hitting the cover off the ball. Shellacks the forehand winner.
You can hear the sound off of the racket of Zverev. So clean and crisp. And he still gets a lot of margin on these shots. He gets spin. He gets it well over the net. So he can hit through on these shots. And it's still a very safe shot.
Winner is updated.
Uchiyama has to take every opportunity he can to move into the court, to get on top of that baseline, and try to dictate as much as possible, as he did in that last point.
Never good, especially now when he's in such a big hole. Double fall for a double break point now. Uchiyama's third double fall to the match. And Zverev can take a stranglehold.
13-14.
Nice response.
Great response. Well placed, out wide. Got a lot of spin. Got a sharp angle on that serve. He has a nice motion. Uchiyama doesn't get quite the pace on his serve. But he can generate good spin, and he places the ball well. So he can have a strong service game just from the ability to move the ball, that serve around the box.
Zverev now 2 of 7 breakpoint attempts in the match. As Uchiyama fights off 2 breakpoints, brings it back to deuce.
And that was a good change up from Uchiyama. It didn't seem like it made a huge difference, but just throwing in that slice, slowing up the pace just enough to throw Zverev off, reduce that unforced error.
And rallies, fights off a couple of break points, and holds for 3-4 second set. Zverev tries a length of the lead when we return to court 11.
The 1991 women's semifinals featured an epic match between 17-year-old Monica Seles and 15-year-old Jennifer Capriati. The match went to a third set tiebreak where Seles came through. Seles would go on to defeat Martina Navratilova in the championship to capture her first U.S. Open title.
Since 1968, covering this great tennis event, last of the four slams, U.S. Open. But to get to the main draw, chance at the greatness, raise that trophy on either side. Men of the women, you've got to get to the quali, several players.
That was an unbelievable match between Seles and Capriati. That was the year I turned pro, so I remember it well. We were the same age, Capriati and I.
13.
Amazing to see somebody that young playing that high level of tennis, and I'm seeing a little bit of that today with Zverev.
That serve overwhelms Uchiyama.
14.
That championship match was only an hour, 6 minutes long. Marcus Seles back in 91. Hard to believe.
Martina didn't look too happy.
No.
In the
not accustomed
there.
To the runner-up trophy or the cup, the plate, right?
That's right. Seles proves she deserved it. Won a few more titles after that. Bit of frustration from Zverev. He clearly wants to close this match out. A little lazy with the footwork on the forehand. Let that ball get down on him. Couldn't quite recover.
13.
He's so far back in the court that he needs a lot more air under that ball. Very smart playing from Uchiyama. Getting those first serves in here.
Applying some pressure. Looking for 4-5 in the second.
That's a great play. Just didn't execute Uchiyama there. Had the open court. Had the benefit of surprise. Might be too little, a little too late.
Double fall for 30 all.
Well, and that's exactly what you don't want to do in this position here if you're Uchiyama. Serving to stay in this match was up 30 love, and now it has tightened up 30 all here.
They're up 2 points for the match. Fourth double fall for Uchiyama today.
Let's.
Unfortunately, those 2 points for Zverev came off of misses. Missed volley and the double fault. Now a second serve.
42% second serve points won to date. That number will go down. Also setting Zverev up. Match point.
13-14.
Well, and it started with the second serve from Uchiyama, but Zverev capitalized immediately, doing exactly what you should to that second serve. shot was Zverev could use the slice. Get that hand off the racket. Give yourself the extra extension. And also neutralize the point. Uchiyama still with some life here in this match.
Advantage,
Uchiyama. Now the service winner. Try to hold serve here for 4-5 in the second. It's a huge difference. First serve points won at 78%, 43% second serve. So he's really effective. And that first ball is in. With an ace, which doesn't hurt. His fifth ace of the match. Brings it to 4-5 in the second. But Zverev from Germany serves for the match. When we return to court 11.
How old do you think it?
Well, here on court 11, the forehand from Zverev has been devastating throughout this match. He gets great extension, good disguise with that upper body turn, and also excellent spin. And he's hit it from the ground, he's hit it from the air, he's hit it inside out, he's hit it down the line, and he is giving Uchiyama all sorts of problems today and is now serving for the match.
Mentioned that semifinal run in Hamburg, Germany, his hometown. After he won the first round match, he said, I'm not sure if I'm dreaming. That was after the first round.
He kept dreaming.
He kept
on dreaming.
Dream.
He's got so many weapons, Zverev, and that's what you look for when you have a young player, particularly a player transitioning to the pro level. Whether they can be successful or not depends on whether or not they can dictate and control points. And it's forcing Uchiyama at times to try to go for a little bit more than he's comfortable going for, because he can't afford to just get the ball back and stay in points.
Uchiyama takes advantage there of the short half volley from Zverev to make it 30 all.
And Uchiyama guessed right off the forehand, and that's what allowed him to get that ball at Zverev's feet. Keeps him in this game at 30 all.
Attacks again. And maybe a miss hit. Backhand drop volley, but he'll gladly take it. It sets up a break point. Let's see.
Well, miss hits count, especially if they land in. And for Uchiyama, that's what he needs to do as much of as he can. Attack and try to dictate.
He meant to punch that deep in the corner, but he'll take it gladly. Ninth ace.
It's almost impossible to attack on those kinds of shots. I mean, that serve is unreturnable. Great disguise from Zverev.
Had six aces in the first set, three in the second. He has not double faulted the entire match.
Thank you.
Advantage, Uchiyama.
Just missed that ball wide. Again, that forehand doing so much damage. Break point opportunity here for Uchiyama.
Just his second of the match, though.
So he won't be too nervous.
Yeah, this is for five all. Second set.
Well, he got a good look at it, Uchiyama. Got the return back deep. And look at a nice forehand. Just could not execute.
Second serve looked long. That's exactly what Uchiyama is talking about here. That was well out. We could see it pretty clearly from our spot.
I mean, what bad luck for Uchiyama. Couldn't have come at a bigger time. Trying to get another breakpoint opportunity.
Zverev will take the break gladly and have his second match point. Take advantage to close out Uchiyama in straight set, 6-4, 6-4. Only 17 years old, the up-and-coming young German star, one step closer to his first-ever trip to the main draw of the U.S. Open.
Well, a disappointing point on the deuce side for Uchiyama, but this point from Zverev, beautifully played, looked like a veteran out there serving and volleying to close out the match. That is just the perfect way. Close it out.
Baby-faced youngster. He fits the part physically at 6'6", but boy, does he look young, right? Congratulations to Zverev from Germany as he advances to the second round of the qualies here at the U.S. Open. After winning three matches, he become one of 16 on each side, the men's and the women's draws, to make the main draw of the U.S. Open, which starts next week. Katrina Adams joined by the happy winner.
Congratulations. Big match for you today. Your serve and your forehand seem to be working for you. Were you pleased with how you played?
Well, yeah, definitely. Especially my first U.S. Open senior match. I mean, even though it's only qualies, but really happy the way I played and really happy the way I served and really hit my forehand well. So just hope I can continue playing like that in the next match and hopefully I can qualify and get to the main draw.
Making the transition from the juniors to the pros, what have your expectations been and are you meeting them?
Well, it's been tough. I mean, the first couple months and the first half year, I didn't really play well, didn't win a lot of matches, and then suddenly just kind of broke the string, and then I just won my first challenger in Braunschweig, then just won my first ATP match and got to the semis in Hamburg, my home city, so I'm really pleased where I am right now.
Congratulations and good luck to you.
Thank you.
Dave, back to you.
Das war ausgezeichnet. Ganz schön prima. Excellent. Really, really good. That's my German for you.
That sounded beautiful.
Zverev advances to the second round. Adam and Jimmy, qualifying update when we return.
welcome you back. Evening upon us here on day one of U.S. Open qualifying on CBS Sports Network. Adam Zucker alongside Jimmy Arias, who's had some very fond memories here in the shadows of Arthur Ashe, where we're coming to you from. And Jimmy, back in 1983, all the way to the semifinals at age 19, top five in the world at that point. Those were good times.
Those were good days. But then a little bit later, I decided to play qualifying and sort of experience what these players are experiencing now. And it's a different time when you're playing qualifying because it's either youngsters coming up. I never got to play it as a youngster coming up. I got to play the qualifying on the other.